What's going on, guys? It is Carly here bringing you another weekly dose of horror. And moving right along, we have Creep from the year 2005. Now, this is a movie I picked up to do on a podcast. I guested on the Cinema Attack podcast, so shout out to them. And it was pretty much a director spotlight on the guy who made this film, which is Christopher Smith. So yeah, I picked it up. Might as well thought, like, why not just add it to my collection instead of renting it? So that's why I bought this DVD. But the plot with this one is you have this girl who, she's like a model agency booker. That's kind of her job. And she is, you know, trying to get a taxi to get home from this event she was at, but she's not successful. So she decides to wait for the next subway to come through. But while she's waiting, she actually ends up falling asleep. And when she wakes up, she realizes everyone else is gone and she's left all alone. And upon, you know, trying to get out, she realizes it's late at night and they actually locked up the whole place and just kind of forgot about her. So she is all alone. And while she's down there, she, you know, happens upon these, I guess, two homeless people, and she's asking them for some help. And along the way, she ends up finding out that they are not completely alone down there, and there's something evil lurking. So yeah, that's basically what's going on with this movie. And I will say, I enjoy this one. I like the main girl. I think she's really good, kind of one of those just strong female characters who is kind of like all business, and you know, then something bad happens to her. The movie, you know, originally kind of reminds me of P2, which obviously that movie is about a girl who gets locked up in a parking garage and, you know, is stalked by a killer guy. It kind of reminds me of that, especially with, you know, this girl, again, is sort of the same type of personality where she's like a hard worker, kind of serious person, and this event kind of happens to her and she's left all alone. So from the start, it reminds me of that, and I really enjoy P2, so that's kind of why I enjoyed this film. But it does have like a turn of events where you find out what's going on down there and you see what's happening and who's lurking down underneath. And that aspect, I like it too. I'm not a huge fan of it because it's not super realistic or anything like that, which, you know, movies don't all have to be realistic, but I just wasn't, it wasn't super, I guess, scary for me or terrifying or anything like that. So for me, it's just like, oh, okay, that's fine. That's a cool way, I guess, for it to go, a cool direction to go. Some people could dig it, some people might not. For me, I'm kind of just lukewarm on it. I don't think it's a bad way to go at all, but at the same time, you know, it's not my favorite thing. But overall, I enjoy the movie. I like the whole subway setting as well. I think it's very creepy, you know, just being alone down there, and it's sort of, it's a big area. It's not like she's just locked in like a room or anything like that. It's like this huge area she has to like scope out and try to figure out a way out of it. And just, you know, you're dealing with dark tunnels and just empty hallways, and just the whole thing is just a very creepy vibe that I know if I was in that situation, I would be pretty freaked out, because you don't know if you're completely alone or not. You can assume it, but you never really know, and in this case, she was not. So yeah, overall, I think it's a solid movie. I like the way it ends and kind of wraps up as well. I think it's a pretty good way to end the film. I give this one a 7.5 out of 10. Yeah, I do recommend it. I think it's, if you like these sort of, I guess, contained horror movies, obviously, that take place in pretty much just one location the whole time, I think you would like this one, because the acting and characters are good with carrying the film, and some scenes are actually pretty brutal as well towards the end. So 7.5 out of 10 for Creep 2005. Thank you again for joining me for this weekly dose of horror, and as always, I'll see you next week.